Saloon, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, and right here on Superstars, this is a title match, and the Rockers, they're all, that's all they are is the challengers.
What do you mean that's all they are until they become champions?
Yeah, but let's see. At the moment of truth, the bell's going to ring here in a second, Roddy Piper. They could freeze.
Ah, no, the Rockers are the team of the 90s. Just check them out.
Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty on their way to the squared circle. And you can bet they're going to be rocking and rolling this week. Tag team specialist, this is a tremendous opportunity for the Rockers.
A lot of momentum by the Rockers, but what happens after the music stops?
What happens after the music stops? Generally speaking, that's where the action begins, and that's what the Rockers... Yeah, we see that, okay.
That's what it's all about, right there, right here on Superstars.
You ever notice how always the skinny little nothing is always causing the big guys to fight?
Well, that's a good point. Mouth in the South, Jimmy Hart, certainly unquestionably an antagonist outside the squared circle, and with that megaphone. Ooh, what a right hand! Look at that! What a cheap shot that was by Knobs! And Knobs with a forearm now. Marty Jannetty caught off guard. Very seldom will that occur. To the buckle, Jannetty, and... Oh, yeah! Jannetty driving Knobs down to the canvas. All 4 men in there right now.
A fantastic move by the Rockers.
And the cover. Come on, Ralph, get over there. Get over there, Ralph. Two.
Oh, wow. Should have been a three,
but it was a two.
And Marty Jannetty winding up. Knobs. Regular face.
That's one way out.
And now Jannetty, whipped to the ropes, coming off, missing with the clothesline, through the legs, off the rope, yes, hooks the hips, one! Now where's the referee? Missing with the clothesline, Science is nailed! What a maneuver there by Marty Jannetty. Science down to the canvas.
Why was it count now?
I'm not too sure he's the legal man.
No, he is the legal man. When he went for the roll-up, there was a tag right there. The Nasty Boys are a tag team all the way, just like the Rockers. Only difference is the Nasty Boys got the belts.
Yeah, well, that's a very big difference. Hair pull from our vantage point. Jannetty now shoved to the far side. Coming back, missing a clothesline, and leapfrogged in. And then put on the brakes. Why not? From the top! Yes!
Unbelievable!
What were you saying?
Still in the ring right now. That's Sags off to Knobs. How about that? Knobs hanging on. And by the way, the Nasty Boys not only having to contend with the Rockers this week, but the Legion of Doom is hot on their trail. We had an occasion to speak to them earlier on.
Nasty Boys, you seem to be enjoying yourself, but we just hope you get by the Rockers in this match. Because then you got us.
That would be a rush. Right now, it looks like that the Rockers and the Nasty Boys are having their own rush in the squared circle. Shawn Michaels, clothesline down to the canvas.
Right now, you're seeing two of the finest tag teams ever put together in the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, wow.
They both have their timing down. What a contest.
What an exciting match, except for one thing.
What?
The winner is the winner, and the loser is the loser. Let's find out what happens.
What a maneuver there by Shawn Michaels. Oh, no. Well,
I don't even know what to say about that.
Maybe nothing, but look at that. Retribution, retaliation there. Right, and again. You can't turn your back on any of these competitors. There's action all around the ring.
I think Sang should tag, just like he did.
Good move. Knobs coming in now on Shawn Michaels. What a matchup. These Rockers having finally the opportunity they've been looking forward to for a long time to be able to wrestle for the tag team championship.
Uh-oh.
And down! The tie already made. And, oh, look at that!
Yes!
What a maneuver by Jannetty!
Non-stop action. Both teams reading the other side. Good on the defense, on the offense. Make
and
the tie!
Tie! Jannetty now coming in. He is all over Sags. From the middle rope, just hurrying away. Wait a minute. Oh, from behind!
Unbelievable!
Yes! Jannetty saw him coming all the way. We're going to have new tag team champions. One, two,
Cover him now again.
Cover who? this looks like there's about 16 guys in the ring.
All four wrestlers in the ring a moment ago, but now it's the Nasty Boys here with maybe a little double tip. The helmet! Jimmy Hart just threw the helmet! Oh, what is that? What a maneuver! And a part of Jannetty! Shawn Michaels and Marvin Jannetty in the ring right now! Bella's run!
The Raptors have won this match. I can't believe it.
Disqualification. The Raptors win the match. They didn't win the championship because you have to make your opponents submit or you have to pin them in order to win a championship. Nonetheless, a gallant effort on the part of the Rockers, and the Rockers one step closer to perhaps a return match.
What did you say, Savage? A win is a win.
The Rockers have proved themselves, I'll guarantee you, right now.
Tag team of the 90s.
Let's take you now to the funeral parlor. Today. He's a man that says he's immortal.
Think the Undertaker's behind there?
The
I don't know. He was at one time, remember?
Federation around his waist. His name is Hulk Hogan.
The host and these fans taking the end now.
I bet he goes to the ring instead of the funeral parlor. I don't think he wants to go there. He's looking at Paul Bearer, and he's looking like he's... Yeah, he's not. He's scared. He's scared, that's why.
Behind the next one, behind door number two, could very well be The Undertaker. You recall that's where he came from to attack, ooh, a warrior from behind, and nobody home. Not this week. Look at the smile on the Hulkster's face. Now he knows it's just himself and Paul Bearer. Look at that look of disdain on the Hulkster's face.
I feel it in the air. I feel fear permeating my funeral parlor, Mr. Hogan, and it's coming from you.
Dr. Paul Bearer, first off, brother, there are thousands of Hulkamaniacs out there, and we fear no man. We fear no beast, we fear no evil, and we don't fear death, because Hulkamania will live forever. You know, Paul Bearer, you deal on a real simple level, brother. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust, and Paul Bearer, the Hulkamaniacs will never trust. You're dealing in mortal life itself. But Hulkamania isn't just flesh and blood, Dr. Paul Bearer. Spiritually, Hulkamania is the strongest force in the universe. And if you had a million caskets, there are a million more Hulkamaniacs. And as long as they train, say their prayers, and eat their vitamins, and believe in themselves, Hulkamania will live forever.
But what about the fear you have for Sergeant Slaughter? You're still bearing the scars.
The scar that hurt Hulkamania the worst was the pain that all my little Hulkamaniacs felt when he burned the Hulkster himself, Dr. Paul Bearer. But you know something? The scar that I'm going to leave Sergeant Slaughter with is going to be a permanent one, so you might as well get one of these caskets ready for Sergeant Slaughter, because I'm going to bury him 6 feet under. But now, Dr. Paul Bearer, there's a casket right there ready for you, and I think it's time we try it out.
Wait a minute. The Hulkster taking Paul Bearer and setting him up in the casket.
If the Hulkster ever decides to bury
Word.
Can I come out now?
Yes. We'll be back.
Gold's Jim, I asked Barry, I said, what month is Mother's Day? He says, May. Or maybe just June.
Will you stop? It's time for Brudeye. Brutus the Barber, meat cake in the barber shop.
A lot of people there need some grooming. They deserve to have him do it.
What, does he look good, Admiral?
Oh, he looks fantastic. Looks like he's gaining a little weight in the upper body. Look at the size of the arms of that guy.
Oh, Cedar Rapids, welcome to the barber shop. You know, tonight, my first appointment is a man who's been with the World Wrestling Federation for many, many years. He's like a legend in his own time. And recently, the Million Dollar Man and Scary Sherry have taken it upon themselves to try to end this individual's career all by themselves. But you know, and I know, that the rowdy one will never, ever stoop down to the level of the Million Dollar Man. That's right, my investment this time, Rowdy, Roddy Piper.
Hot Rod always got a smile on his kisser, Admiral.
Oh, yeah. Unless you get him mad.
Then you got a guy in a leather jacket and a skirt mad at you.
Wow.
Not the leather jacket.
Doesn't have the clutch anymore either.
Hang on a second. I wanna say something here. First of all, I want you to have a seat, Mr. Brudeye, because I got a little something I wanna tell you about men. I wanna tell you about what you are. You just get over here and get yourself comfy. I know it's your barbershop. A little trim around the ears, you're looking great. You know, this man right here, Mr. DiBiase, a little lesson for you here. This man right here, 8 months ago, was in the ocean, treading water, playing with the sharks. I don't know what you're doing. Turn around, and somebody hits him in the face and tears his face off. This guy right here now. Now, for 3 days, he's in the hospital. He's not waking up. He's basically sipping tea with the angels is what he's doing. Everybody knows he wakes up 3 days later. This is a man now. He wakes up 3 days later. He's got, 30 screws in the head, 8 plates in the face, face all popped up. People saying to him, you ain't never gonna do it again. You finished, you down, you out. Baloney! Money can't buy, and that's the will. You know, we got a friend of all of ours, Michael Landon, just found out he got cancer, and I was reading, and he come public. I'm sitting here worried about my little knee, man. I'm in company. Michael Landon got cancer, and he says, I ain't gonna quit. It's all in the attitude. I can't pull it through. I'm sitting here with him, a man that did pull it through. Not only that, 8 months later, you come out, you be in shape, and you got your own barbershop. That is pure man. And I'll tell you something, DiBiase, the thing you can't buy is heart. The thing you can't buy is that human instinct. And if Michael Landon ain't quitting, if he didn't quit, I'll be damned if I'm gonna quit. And you know something? You just can't keep a good man down.
Quit, not in the vocabulary of Brutus the Barber, Beef King, or the Hot Rod. I'm gonna go get Mr. Perfect. I've seen enough of this as your life. Get out! Impact here in Cedar Rapids, Iowa. Intercontinental Championship match. Has got to be concerned, Admiral.
Yes, I would say very concerned. I think Mr. Perfect is even more concerned because
he's got a lot of weight to handle.
Certainly does. And Starkbolt's hovering around that 500-pound mark.
I don't think Mr. Perfect's going to be doing any bear hugs around him.
I don't think so either.
Our body slam.
Another reason why I'm glad we've got this title match here this week on Challenges, because it gets that piece of garbage out of the broadcast table here and sends him down the ringside, and we don't have to deal with him.
And that is so refreshing.
Oh, tremendous. They could get him a job with Ringling. Hey! I have to have some words with him about that. She said 384 pounds?
Yeah, maybe when Tugboat was back in the sixth grade, yeah.
You know, when you're that big, where do you go? Down to the shipyards and hang on the meat scales? Or you know, where do you get weighed, Anvil?
That's a very good question. Possibly putting two scales together, I don't know.
Title on the line. Match of tremendous magnitude.
Look at the look on Mr. Perfect's face. Doesn't look too cocky now.
Of course, Tugboat right off the bat at a disadvantage. He has to deal with the brain out there. The weasel roaming around the ringside.
Mr. Perfect having advantage on the speed category.
Look, he stopped the match twice already, Andrew. One thing you won't stop, that's Hot Ticket. It debuts this Sunday, May 5th, everywhere on a pay-per-view basis. All the tremendous history and heroes of WrestleManias 1-7. You know, Anvil, Hot Rod, Rowdy Piper, who we saw only moments ago here on Wrestling Challenge, involved in WrestleMania 1, where he teamed up with Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, against the Hulkster and Mr. T. And then in WrestleMania 2, Hot Rod put the boxing gloves on against Mr. T. Boy, I remember that so vividly.
Oh, yes. And they trained so hard for that boxing match, too. It was tremendous.
Trained in Philadelphia at Joe Frazier's gym.
Mr. Perfect having a little problem, getting knocked out right in his little touch.
Oh, isn't that sweet? That was just to get your attention, Mr. Perfect. He's not even sweating. He hasn't done anything yet, Anvil.
I think he's going to start to sweat pretty soon.
You're perfect and he's stupid.
Tugboat needs to get in there and get his hands on Mr. Perfect. Get his arms around him. Lock him on a good hold.
Perfect forcing Tugboat back into the corner.
Tugboat got too big of a chest. Too much meat up there.
Concerned look on the face of the brain. His only claim to fame right now in the Heenan family, of course, Mr. Perfect.
Well, this might come to a very quick end here.
Wouldn't that be something if we see the Intercontinental title change hands right here on Wrestling Challenge?
Yes, it would. Look at the concern on Heenan's face.
You might just see somebody go into cardiac arrest.
Yeah.
Referring to the brain, of course.
Mr. Perfect having a few problems here. Uh-oh, going out again. What could they be talking about?
I think they're just trying to buy time here. Well, obviously the brain just told him to use your speed, use your agility, get around this guy, but he got caught. Go over and get some more advice. Irish whip by the big guy.
There we go. Yeah, get out of that one, Mr. Perfect.
Perfect in a whole heap of trouble here this week on Wrestling Challenge. A couple of shots right to the eye. Still the big guy didn't turn him loose. Irish whip follows him in, but whoa, a little bit
Maybe a step or two late on that angle.
It just pinch late. Throws Mr. Perfect off. There's a lot of force.
Wham!
Those hurt.
Tugboat. Second turnbuckle on the inside, but off. Perfect gone. Hooks the leg and some of the pants. He got a three count. I don't think the referee saw that.
That was a very fast three count.
Here's Mike.
Boy, will the brain be gloating when he gets back here, Andrew.
I think the brain and Mr. Perfect really lucked out with this one.
Hot Ticket debuting this Sunday, May 5th. History and heroes of the World Wrestling Federation. WrestleMania's 1-7 on a pay-per-view basis. Don't miss it.
I heard you were coming. Let's see. It's Mama's Day today, isn't it? I never met much of a mother's boy, but... Let me see now. Oh, I got it. Okay. M is for the many ways. You cost me money, DiBiase. O is for the operation on my knee. T's for the countless times you ran away from me. H is for that hairy beast you call a manager. E's for the error that Martel's gonna make by fighting me this day. And R just for Rowdy Roddy. This one's for you, Mama.
I've just been investigating the tax returns of certain superstars. And just as I suspected... They're as dishonest as the rest of you. Nothing but a bunch of small-time swindling tax cheats. Why, take a look at this clown's return. Who does he think he is claiming bird food as a business deduction? And this guy, asking the government to reimburse him for travel expenses incurred by his bulldog? Where do these guys get off, anyway? Well, they're not going to get away with it anymore. Not while IRS is on the case. These guys may be superstars, but in my eyes, they're nothing but a bunch of dishonest, dirty, flim-flamming thieves.
I think we got a problem, Vince McMahon. You're closer to Piper than I am. Why don't you tip him off that IRS is after him? That's who he was talking about right at the end there.
Flim, flammy. Ooh,
that's Roddy. That's
that.
Roddy. I like Roddy, but, you know, we don't see eye to eye on everything. You know how it is.
Well, here we go. They take care of thieves down in Cobb County, Georgia. The Big Boss Man. Big Boss Man, by the way, before the broadcast, wanted to make sure that we said hello to Mama Boss Man here on Mother's Day.
I'll tell Bobby Heenan to pass the word along also.
No, I don't think that would be too smart.
Okay, that's okay. I'll just back up on that one little point.
Big Boss Man squaring off against Dan Johnson. Boss Man, oh my goodness.
There's a baby Boss Man right there.
How about it, huh? Boss Man with Johnson up against the rope. Asked for the clean break. Johnson. Oh, wow. My goodness. What an uppercut.
The ropes are keeping him up.
My goodness. George Foreman eats your heart out. Johnson off the rope. Boss Man with an elbow. Out of the canvas. And I would suggest that the Boss Man has the law and order around these parts, although the Maldi may differ with that point of view. But wait a minute. Right there on the cover of the magazine available this Tuesday is You Know Who.
That's right, the Macho Man holding You Know Who on his shoulder, but my picture could have been a little bit bigger.
Maybe. Boss Man driving Johnson down. That could be it. Yes. Three count. It's all over.
Hard time, the Big Boss Man. Yeah, victory. What you gonna do now, huh?
Well, it's just time for a little interrogation. You know, after a tough match and so forth, you want to make sure that you have all the right answers from your...
Out of nowhere, yeah. The Nasty Boys.
That's right.
Look at this, going to work at a Boss Man. Jimmy Hart right behind. And you know what that means? The Melody's probably right behind them. I can't believe this. What a blatant attack on the Big Boss Man. Sags and knobs. Tag team champions all over the Boss Man. They're handcuffing him now. Trying to get the cuffs on him. Boss Man trying to escape. Jimmy Hart leading the way. Sags and Knott, tag team champions.
Oh, come on.
Get in there, official. Do something about this.
They got him locked to the rope right now. Big Boss Man want to give everybody a hard time. What's going on now?
Knott and Sags with Jimmy Hart giving direction. They're all over the Big Boss Man. Just all over. And look who's coming down. This is the man who unquestionably set this whole thing up. He unquestionably set it up. Look at this. He claims he's the law and order of the Mountie Doves. Look at him swaggering down the ringside.
The wheels of justice have turned, and the Mountie hears that the Big Boss Man wanted him one-on-one, so here's the opportunity for the Big Boss Man. Let's see what he can do.
What a treacherous trick on the part of the Mountie, sending down the Nasty Boys.
Quinn is pumped, no doubt, but here's a guy who's pumped in a different manner. He's all pumped out, I think.
Good evening. Come a little closer.
Sure.
Don't be afraid. I'm always happy to have visitors in my parlor. You know, in my years of being a mortician, I have had the privilege of serving many families in my time. And you must remember that the funeral is not for the deceased, not for the deceased at all. The funeral is for the living, for the family. And at this time, I would like to swing the doors of my mortuary wide open to welcome a very prominent family led into the funeral home by Bobby the Brain Heenan. I welcome the Intercontinental Champion, Mr. Perfect.
Well, Mr. Perfect gets a real close look at the funeral parlor.
Gotta be tentative. How would
this?
Sir,
we seem to have a problem. You see, our problem stems from a bulldog. A mean, vicious, little, snarling, rabid, flea-infested bulldog that has to be laid to rest. Can you help us with our problem?
Of course, I can handle any kind of service.
We need a casket.
Well, we have a large one.
No, that won't do.
How about a medium-sized coffin?
No, that won't do.
Well, how about this small little casket right here? How do you like this one?
That casket is You know, British Bulldog, once you meet Paul Bear, this is the last stop for you. And I got this to say to you, British Bulldog. Everything I've done in the World Wrestling Federation has been perfect. This man has something for everybody. And this one is for Winston, and the one will be made for you. You, my friend, and myself, maybe have a lot in common. Because no matter who I face, British Bulldog, starting with you, we'll end up here. I have a new slogan for you. You stop them, you box them.
We'll be back as we continue with Rowdy Roddy Piper one-on-one with the model. You know, the more I think about it, the more I think it was totally despicable to have a small little coffin there that allegedly Winston is going to be placed in at the hands of Mr. Perfect.
What do you want to do? Just forget about Winston after it's all over? Do you want everybody to be kind of happy that we kind of celebrate the type of a thing where he's headed?
What did that mean?
I'm not sure, but the model is about to enter the squared circle, and he's going to be going against a guy that steals the spotlight anytime he can, Rowdy Roddy Piper.
I say, yes, indeed. And the model looking good these days. No question of that.
Yes, he is.
He's, let's see, I think the word you use is styling.
He and color coordinated at the same time.
Oh,
yes.
I see.
Even his arrogance is the same color as his tights and his knee pads. Did you notice that?
No, as a matter of fact, I've never seen arrogance. I have smelled it, however. It's sort of akin to the sardines on a Bushwhacker. And listen to this.
This guy right here walks to the ring and electrifies everybody. Look at that. Look at that $100 smile, man. He's there.
That's $1 million smile. That's not $100 smile.
Look at that. He's thinking about Ted DiBiase. That he better have his mind on the model Rick Martel. Unquestionably one of the top contenders here in the World Wrestling Federation.
And you know that Rick Martel is hoping for a win, because a win over Roddy Piper could put him right up there, right near the top.
Standing ovation for Rowdy Roddy Piper. You will recall Mr. Piper, in honor of Mother's Day, dedicated this match to his mom.
That's right, and he's going to get defeated. And if his mother's a true friend of his, well, I think she ought to disown him anyway. Look at the look on Piper.
Yeah, Rowdy Roddy Piper preparing to lock up with the model, Rick Martel.
All right, the model displaying his physique.
The model could be in the WWF Championships all by himself right there. Yeah, but he's got to take off his wrestling shoes. I know that. Martel's reading him the riot act.
Model turns his back on Rowdy Roddy Piper.
And the right hand is flat. Piper hammering away on the model with Martel. Martel off the rope.
Nice hip toss by Rowdy Roddy Piper.
Here comes the clothesline through the ropes to the outside.
Unbelievable. Piper's going crazy out there. I think he's visualizing that that's the $1 million man or something.
From the apron down. And uh-oh.
That jump was too much. He's got a bad knee. He doesn't want to admit it. He's trying to be a tough guy.
Race reversal. Look at that maneuver. Rowdy Roddy Piper, yes, may have the bad knee, but nonetheless, taking it to Rick DeMato Martel.
Piper.
Wait a minute. There's the $1 million man, Mr. DiBiase. It appears as though Rowdy Roddy Piper's knee is pretty much 100%.
Oh, isn't that sweet? Obviously, Piper, you've thrown away the clutch. I hope you haven't thrown it too far prematurely.
That's right, Piper, because you're going to need it in the very near future.
Well, it jammed. It seemed like Piper jammed his knee when he got outside, but right now it looks like it's fine. And uh-oh.
There's a good short jab right there by the model. And Piper's definitely going about 98%. Ooh, look at that.
There he go again, jamming that knee.
And the referee asking Mr. Piper about the injury. Oh, look at this. The model, Rick Martel, going to work on it.
That's the way it is in the World Wrestling Federation. Tough guys, they go to the top. Look at that, right on the leg. Yeah, Martel's not making no bones about it. He's going after the injury.
Rowdy Roddy Piper grimacing in pain is the model, Rick Martel, is in control, and perhaps this was not such a good idea after all for Rowdy Roddy Piper to be taking on the model.
I knew that from the start, but Piper got all upset about the $1 million man Ted DiBiase and Sensational Sherry, and he threw away the crutch, and now he's suffering the consequences. Too bad, Piper.
Maybe more guts than brains. Oh, come on, what is this? What a despicable thing to do. The referee should get in there. Piper in trouble. The model going to work on the damaged knee. Taking off the bandage, taking off the support. The model ripped Martel all over Rowdy Roddy Piper now. A right hand. Piper firing back. And wait a minute, up he goes. And he gave right out. Did he get two and three? He got him. No.
No, he did not get him right there. No, he did not. But he will in the future right now because Piper's already
hurt. A leg, two and a kick out there with authority by Mr. Piper.
Now, that was closer to a three count than the other count.
A blatant chokehold by the model, Rick Martel. You can bet DiBiase thus far is very much enjoying this match.
You look at the people. They're trying to give him some momentum. I don't doubt that Roddy Piper has a lot of fans in this building.
The model, Rick Martel now from the corner. What's he going to do? Off and oh, Piper beats him to the punch.
Piper's leg gave out even then, Vince McMahon. I'm telling you right now, he hasn't got a chance.
Oh, no.
I don't know what that hold is. I've never used that one.
Well, I don't think Roddy Piper knew where he had the model. Nonetheless, Rick Martel is in trouble now.
Ooh, yeah.
He's in big trouble.
This reminds me of a rodeo right now.
Piper with that bandage wrapped around the throat of the model, Rick Martel. And now, Rowdy Roddy Piper taking over on the model. Just hammering away. Oh. Roddy Piper with the model over the top rope to the eyes.
He held on to that. His vicious thing. Piper is a vicious man. Don't tell me he's not vicious. I know who's vicious, and I know who's not vicious in the World Wrestling Federation.
Roddy Piper may be vicious, but perhaps not as vicious as the $1 million man, Ted DiBiase. Oh, my, there's a wake-up call.
Drinks for everybody. Piper's buying.
Roddy Piper hammering on the model. Rick Martel throws him back into the ring. Piper again favoring that left knee. Yeah. And now beginning to beg off a bit. The model. Roddy Piper all over him. You do Mr. Piper wrong, and you're going to pay. Roddy now, reverse to the rope. Model missing. Piper going downstairs again, and small package. He gets it.
Unbelievable, one-legged victory.
Roddy, Roddy Piper, victorious over Model Rick Martel.
Look at Piper, look at those eyes. Those aren't the eyes of a sane individual.
Maybe not. Let's go back to the replay.
Right there, ducks the clothesline. A punch to the belly, doubles him up, slips in the small package, and hooks everything that could be loose. Piper's a technician in the ring also. Ooh, yeah, look at that.
Rock, rock's all right.
Piper
but can
loves
he
it.
Rock against the $1 million man?
I say no.
Hudson O'Warrior, next week we meet right here. You're the kind of guy, when somebody punches you, you punch back. When somebody kicks you, you kick back. Well, I'm the kind of guy that always gets the last punch, always gets the last kick. And at the end of the match, it's going to be the end of your career. Next week.
My warriors have walked over. My warriors have walked through. But they have never walked around any challenge in the World Wrestling Federation. Next week, I will take you, Smash. Once part of a great and powerful tag team, I will take you and smash you into the sacred ground so that the warriors, the skeletons of my warriors' past, can feast.
One of my favorite times of the year, Mom's Day weekend. A chance to show your mother what you really think of her. And, well, I know you spent a lot of money on Mother's Day buying a nice gift.
Oh, yes, you only have one mother.
I can't wait to get back to Beverly Hills and find out what my mom got me.
Got you? What do you mean, got you?
Mother's Day.
You're supposed to get her something.
No, not at our house. She gets me stuff.
Right, anybody could be your father, but you only got one mother. Remember that.
Right, and one gift I don't think's enough. She could get me two, maybe.
Oh.
Money's no object, I told her.
You're disgusting.
You won't offend me with cash.
They're going to blow the lid off Cedar Rapids here.
They should.
Animal and Hawk.
Take the rest of the state with them.
Just a question of time in my book, Animal, until the WWF tag team belts are around the waist of Animal and Hawk.
Well, I'm sure the Nasty Boys are going to have their hands full of Legion of Doom.
And everybody I talk to says, there is the next World Wrestling Federation tag team champion.
I just said that.
I know, I'm just saying the people I talk to seem to think that way.
You mean Haku the Barbarian?
No, I talk to other people besides those two members of my family.
Ingrates, you almost said.
I didn't
Ingrates.
Say that.
You were insinuating.
You're going to start trouble in the family now.
That's not hard to do.
Our WWF fans in Portland, Maine and surrounds will look forward, no doubt, to Thursday night, May 30th. We return to the Cumberland County Civic Center with a live event of WWF action. The Bushwhackers will be on the card. You'll see the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, Hacksaw, Jim Duggan, and others in Portland, Maine, Thursday night, May 30th at the Cumberland County Civic Center.
About four or five reverse knife edges in a row, and whoa,
stunned him.
Got his attention.
I don't know if you want to get Animal's attention.
Oh, what a move. Caught him in midair. Turned it into a beauty of a power slam.
Look out, Animal up there.
Where's he going to dump him? In the eighth row, maybe.
Ooh, show mercy there, Anvil.
When you slam from that far up, believe me, that hurts the lower back.
It's like an Oriental Cabbage Patch doll the way he picked him up.
Tanaka now taking over. His mastery of the martial arts, second to none.
Think these guys spend any time in the gym, Anvil?
Oh, baby, you know it. You don't look like that by accident. They're in great shape. You know what LOD means, really, don't you?
What? No, but I'm afraid you'll tell us.
Legion of Dummies. Ooh. Not many people know that, but that's their true name, the Legion of Dummies.
Oh, look at that! From the outside, reverse crescent kick by Kato. That slowed down. Hawk, in a hurry, stopped him dead in his tracks. Look at this. Pile driver with assistance.
It's over. He's up. I can't believe it, he's up.
Well, neither can the Orient Express, Crane. Kato doing the smart thing, taking a little high ski for himself.
Whoa!
Animal's gonna help him back here. What's that like? And Hawk once again.
And Hawk helps him out.
Just trying to be courteous.
It's like a hole. This is like a revolving door.
No way out. Find your way in, but you can't find your way out.
At the Roach Motel.
Well, you can bet, Brain, that that little runt, Jimmy Hart, and the Nasty Boys are worried. Earlier on, we had a chance to speak with them.
Legion of Doom, you're next, baby. LOD, do we look worried? Get ready for the nastiest time of your life. What a rush, big muscles, painted faces, and shoulder pads with spikes. You ain't nasty, and you ain't the champions. Get ready for the nastiest time of your life.
Get ready for the nastiest time of your life?
I think Legion of Doom could well have said that, Manuel.
Yes.
I think the Nasty Boys ought to do a little work on their legs when they go against the Legion of Doom. Because the power difference here is going to be tremendous.
Oh, look at this. Power display and double noggin knocker by the Animal. Really turned the table.
Oh, salt. What was that? Salt in the face?
Iodized. That'll slow you down.
Bombs away.
He's still on his feet. That amazes me. Most people give up by now. Most people are out. They can't take anymore. He's still on his feet.
I think the Nasty Boys' brain are taking a close look at that as well.
But you got to look at it this way. The Nasty Boys are the champions.
That's correct.
And they have Jimmy Hart.
Well, that's a detriment, I think. You had Jimmy Hart, Andrew. You won't know what that's all about.
Yeah, and it was a living nightmare every minute of the day. You profited by it. Hey, you stabbed him in the back. I could tell you stories about Jimmy Hart with your toenails. Tell me.
Another whip in and another clothesline.
When we're off the air, I want to know some of this. When we're off the air, I'm going to know some of this stuff. I can use, I mean, I can help maybe.
He could use it, yeah.
No, I don't mean it that way.
Whoa! Oh, what a backdrop!
Had to be 9 or 10 feet up in the air. At least.
Look at this, slingshot his own man with a clothesline.
Fatal's going to need the Undertaker pretty soon.
Animal says elevator up.
Elevator down. Going down.
That could just as easily be the Nasty Boy. Let's go up and get the official word. They can make it look easy against anybody. Right now, it's time for our special report. Take it away.
Yo! The doctor is here, Daddy. That's it. I hope that's right, brother. Hey, come on over here. Come on over here, brother. Let me rap to you. Listen.
Hey, Lana, I want to be your manager.
That's right.
Listen, I manage the Warlord and Power and Glory. Hey, and each one of them got a bad boy just like one of these. Hey, check out that Persian rug interior for the trunk. But no. Better than that for you. That's right. I'm talking about a gold-plated... Oh, Lord. You understand what I'm saying?
Well, you better clean out the garbage.
Garbage? What garbage, Holmes? Hey, what you doing? Hey, wait a minute.
Next stop, New Jersey.
Hot ticket is, in fact, hot brain. I've ordered it. I've been watching.
Here's a hot item right here.
The barber. It's amazing. The guy doesn't have 2.5 yards of clothing on.
Gentlemen, welcome. My next appointment is just here, just arrived. It's none other than Jake the Snake Roberts.
Well, very unhappy, I might add, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Looks like he's got a new friend with him.
He lost the pamphlet.
No, he's wearing them.
A special relationship between you and Damien. And everyone knows that Damien is no longer with us. But one thing I gotta know, Jake, is what's on your mind, brother? What's going through your head after you were tied helplessly in the ropes in that big natural disaster? The earthquake was stomping a mud puddle in Damien.
Damien is dead. Damien is gone. But the snake is still standing. That's what I'm thinking about.
It takes a real big man earthquake to stomp on a snake that's defenseless and totally tied in a bag. What kind of man would do something like that?
You know what I think sometimes, man, when you really think about it, he has proven only one thing. He is not afraid of the snake as long as it is in the bag. But you know, when I think back of all the great hunters of the past and people that call themselves great hunters, what would they do if the animals had guns to shoot back? What kind of game would it be then? Would it be a game then? Would it be a nice day to go hunting? Or are you going to worry about the rabbit with the big gun? Well, what I'm telling you is very simple, Earthquake. Damien is gone, brother, and to make me watch what you did was no less than rape. That's what it was to me. You reached into my soul and left a mark on my heart. But the only way I can deal with it is the same way that you had to deal with it. You can roll over and die, or you can get yourself a bigger snake. I choose to get myself not only a bigger snake, but a nastier snake. Maybe a snake just like me. One with a real cold heart. So when I thought about this, I said it's only right that that snake should be none other than Damien's big brother, the devil himself, Lucifer. Now that's something you don't play with.
Lucifer!
Well, do you think I could have just a little peek in Lucifer?
Shall we? Why not?
Let's just open it up.
I'm gonna show you.
Whoa, you are serious, man. What could do that?
What could that do to a man, Jake?
Earthquake, Lucifer is here to greet you, and Lucifer is here to eat you.
Wow.
What is this? Your car is blocking some young lady who wants to get out of there.
I'm doing a television show. I'm hosting my program here. I can't move my car.
This is a pregnant lady, apparently.
I never touched her.
Your car is blocking her. Go move your car.
Tough. I'm doing a television show. Hey. Can you wait or have the kid in the front seat? I don't care.
That could be a future Legion of Doomer out there. Move it.
I'm not leaving my program. I'm hosting. If I left, it's all
part. Don't worry, little man. We'll move the car for it. This stuff's got to fester a little longer anyways. All right, let's go move the car. All right. Animal, this has got to be his car. Someone took the finger.
It's got to be
his car. Move it. Move it. Oh, yeah. Easy. That a boy. Come on, man.
Go ahead, your baby, man. Move it.
Come on. Yeah. Come on. Boy. Like working in a parking lot.
In the World Wrestling Federation, here is the Earthquake.
Yes, indeed, you've been doing just fine in the World Wrestling Federation as of late. There are a few individuals that have your girth and know how to use it in the squared circle, no question of that. But what you did recently, I think, probably is one of the most heinous acts we've ever seen in the World Wrestling Federation, and it's certainly not anything to laugh at all. If we can take you to some footage, we will show you what the Earthquake accomplished when he had the opportunity. The pet of Jake the Snake, Damien.
Just remember who forced the confrontation.
And one time wasn't enough. You had to come back and do it a second time.
It's lucky I didn't do it three times.
How could you? How could you possibly do something like that? Sure, you're afraid of snakes, but the snake didn't deserve to die.
Listen, Jake Roberts forced the confrontation. He made me a desperate man. I did what I had to do to get rid of the problem, and that's it.
Well, you think you got rid of the problem. You didn't.
Well, look. This is a present that I want you to give to Jake Roberts. Give it back to him. It's Damien.
Can I pet him?
You know, he always likes to put the snake around people. Why don't you just go give this back to Jake Roberts? And while you're at it, I got one more present for him. And it goes to that Taj Mahal. Here's some dice for him. They always come up snake eyes. And you can give those to him too, compliment to the Quake.
Let's take you to action now involving Jake the Snake Roberts. And Damien may not be with us anymore, but you just took a look at Lucifer, and how are you going to contend with Lucifer?
Well, Lucifer is bigger than Damien. But the only time that Roberts uses that snake is after the DDT, and Roberts cannot DDT the Quake, and I'll tell you that right now, McMahon.
I disagree with you wholeheartedly on that. Jake the Snake Roberts in the frame of mind, and I believe he can do it. And if he does, just think of what's going to come out of the bag.
Well, just think of it. If it doesn't come out, the same thing will happen to Lucifer that happened to Damien.
Earthquakes always come in pairs, you know that.
You know, McMahon, I am not only a great wrestler. I'm a great eater, too. I'm a great cook. So what I'm going to do for you on prime time right now, I'm going to go out and prepare specialty just for you guys.
Like what?
Specialty.
I'm going to make some Quake burgers. You're going to love them. You're going to love them.
I've heard his reputation as a chef.
Quake burgers?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, thank you very much for joining us.
You'll love them. I'll be done.
Earthquake.
We'll be back with more Primetime Wrestling.
Are you ready for the...
I'm ready.
Is the Earthquake ready?
I think he is. I can smell it in the air.
All right. The Earthquake earlier on, as you know, when we have to cook some Quake burgers.
The Earthquake is scheduled to join us.
Oh, my goodness.
Since I've been gone, take that one right there. Try a Quake burger, Bobby.
Thank you.
Hey, well, try one of those, Lord.
I'll have this one from the middle, just
one.
Those are those good ones. I'll try it.
All right, I'll try it.
You know, I know it's a snake skinny game, but what did you do with the inside? All that dust, did you ground it up or did it get ground round?
Not too bad, but really not too good.
Oh, hey, so,
I don't want to offend you.
Hey, man, you're going to get the desire to crawl under a bush and lay in the lawn for a while, McMahon.
What are you trying to say?
What do you think I'm trying to say, dummy?
This is good hamburger.
Very nice, Bobby. I like it.
What are you trying to say?
You can either eat these or make the pair of shoes out of them.
Do you find that humorous? Is this honest to God what you claim it is?
This is my Quake burger. That's all I got to say.
What is Quake fine with?
I don't think this is funny at all. I don't think this is funny.
I only make these once in a while, Vince.
But you know, I hear you may be making another batch for him soon.
Beautiful English manners.
That's a snake.
What?
That's a snake you was alluding to.
Now you got it, Lamy. Now you got it.
That's terrible. I've consumed part of that too. How repulsive.
You guys are. Well, that one's been eaten already, or maybe that's just the eye.
This is disgusting. You're a disgusting human being.
Oh, come on.
You are absolutely disgusting. Like Damien, and this is what you do. You bring his skin out earlier on, you bring this out, you think this is funny, you've been cooking, you think this is funny?
I gotta eat.
I think that Smash and Fuji have a little edge.
knowing the history of Ultimate Warrior, we want to see when he comes out, just his approach here. Look at this.
The Ultimate Warrior making his first appearance on Superstar since the last time we saw him in the funeral parlor. Your point well taken, Rowdy Roddy Piper. Is this still the same competitor we have always known him to be?
He's looking at it, but then again, Smash certainly ain't backing up. It's going to be one heck of a contest here.
Well, that took a little bit out of him, I'll say that. But I'll tell you what, Paul Bearer really told the Ultimate Warrior what it was all about. And this is a big day and a big match for the Ultimate Warrior. Smash will take it, I guarantee it.
Any stake that the Ultimate Warrior is just simply not the same competitor since being placed in that coffin by the Undertaker.
Guy's got a right to be a little bit intimidated, maybe. The guy's got a right to be a little rattled in the brain. But now we're going to see if he's got the guts to muster it all back up and use the force in a positive way.
Let me tell you something. The whole world is watching, Ultimate Warrior.
Yes, and now we see some power exerted by Smash. And again, is the Warrior looking into the eyes of Smash and seeing the eyes of the Undertaker. You have to wonder. Locked back up now, and oh, man, Smash for the ride. Smash coming back out. And down to the canvas. One right hand sends him down another one. Smash now changing his tactics, maybe too late, to the buckle. The Ultimate Warrior moving right in. Series of kicks to the midsection. And the Warrior really taking it to Demolition Smash.
You want to watch Fuji, though? Whoa! Took his eyes off him. Maybe that casket did do something for him. Made him nearsighted.
I think it did. I think it chills him when he thinks about it at night.
Maybe, maybe not. Demolition Smash, a tremendous competitor. Smash and the Ultimate Warrior going at it. A very physical type of a match. A hell of Steven. Oh, my. Smash ran right into that foot. Warrior off the rope. A tackle nicely executed. Off the rope again. Over Smash. The Ultimate Warrior puts on the bridge and down goes Smash.
Right there, the Ultimate Warrior's looking up in the air when he should be getting on Smash right there.
I don't sense any hesitation at all on the part of the Warrior. None. If you were looking to see a little bit of fear, maybe a little bit of intimidation on the part of the Warrior, I don't think we've seen it yet.
Well, there's Fuji's dinner in his beard, though.
Well, it happens more often than not, I'll have to say.
Yeah, we're going to see.
Ultimate Warrior hammered now by Demolition Smash. This, perhaps, will be the true test for the Warrior.
We're going to see just how much guts he can muster. You know, it's easy when you're on a flow. You've beaten a guy and another guy and another guy, and you're on a run. The Ultimate Warrior's had a piece taken out of his heart. Now's the time to show us. Now's the time to muster the strength. Now's the time for gold power.
And the Warrior snapped over, and Smash is in control. Bye. Down into the chest, down in the sternum area. Demolition Smash hammering away.
I know you don't like to hear it, Vince McMahon and Roddy Piper, but I think the pressure has gotten to the Ultimate Warrior. The people are expecting too much of him, and he's left everything that he used to be in the funeral parlor.
I don't know about that. Again, I'm sure it was a traumatic experience. Imagine gasping for your last breath.
Look out, come on.
Gasping for your last breath, losing consciousness inside your very own coffin, trying to claw your way out of it, but to no avail. That, unquestionably, will have a lasting effect on the Warrior forever. Oh, no, that might as well.
That could do it right there. We could have a count out right now. The Ultimate Warrior falling asleep on the outside.
Falling asleep?
Well, he almost got knocked out right there. He's crawling, but what if he doesn't get back into the ring before the end of the count?
I'll tell you what, Smash, if he was smart, ought to go over and drag the Warrior in and go for the pin, because I don't think he's ever going to have him at a better disadvantage than now.
Great
right
point.
Hand finds
right
his mark.
There.
Smash on the outside, taking it to the Ultimate Warrior. And you can... Oh, yeah? And you can bet the Undertaker is looking on, along with his manager, the Paul Bearer. Looking on and enjoying this part of the matchup.
Smash better stop talking about it and start trying to pin the Ultimate Warrior here. Doing a lot of talking. I mean, here's a prime position to go for the pin, and he's just jerking around.
I think that Smash realized that the Ultimate Warrior hasn't got what he had before.
I don't believe that.
Oh, you don't believe it? What are we watching right here?
Demolition Smash hammering away on the Ultimate Warrior in the back area. Demolition Smash perhaps sensing victory, but the Ultimate Warrior beginning to get it together. The Ultimate Warrior perhaps remembering exactly how he felt in that casket. He doesn't want to go back in. No way. The Ultimate Warrior on a roll with tremendous momentum now. The Warrior blocking the right hand and fails Demolition Smash. And again, smash down to the canvas. Warrior up with a clothesline. Coming off the other side of the rope and under the clothesline. The Warrior on a tear and Demolition Smash is being smashed. Warrior now from the near side and what a tackle.
Go for the cover.
Warrior up and down across the chest. One, two, yes.
Is that a few questions?
But the Undertaker still has his number, and his number is number 1,000.
The Undertaker looking on, no doubt, and looking forward to the opportunity to putting the Ultimate Warrior back in the coffin.
What?
Back in the coffin.
Everything you said was wrong, man. The guy's got it together. Look at him. He's getting his confidence now. Check it out.
Let's take you now to the update.
Big Boss Man, I warned you, but you broke my international law. I sentenced you, and I punished you. But out of goodness of my heart, I showed you a little mercy. If there's a next time, you won't be so lucky.
How'd you like to see that sight coming up your lawn?
I don't think I'd like to see it, because it means one thing. You're going to be audited.
D.C., weighing 248 pounds, here is Irwin R. Shyster, otherwise known as IRS.
Hey, Irwin.
Well,
nice to see you, Irwin.
What's wrong with Irwin?
Nothing, just Irwin. Kind of.
I mean, does he look like an Irwin to you?
Oh, yes.
He
yes,
does?
Yes.
That's
yes.
What an Irwin looks like.
Irwin, you know.
You are the saddest looking bunch of tax cheats I've ever seen in my life.
Ebenezer.
Go ahead, cheat on your taxes. Because when I find you, IRS, I'm coming to your house and visit. And you're gonna pay big time.
Well, I don't think he has ingratiated himself with this capacity crowd at all. Although I don't think what's in the attaché case? When the glasses go in.
It's a large glasses case there.
Mm-hmm. I wonder what else he has in there. Irwin R. Shyster, IRS.
Don't you think you should have come with your trunks on there, son?
I think you did.
And cool. Irwin's got cool-looking trunks, doesn't he?
Yeah, but I don't know about that tie. Irwin riding Red Tyler down to the canvas.
Now, Macho Man, now, if you were wrestling Irwin, wouldn't you grab all of that tie and take him for a hog ride?
I don't know. I'd straighten it for sure. It's just a little bit crooked. That's the only thing that's crooked on IRS, though, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, I bet it's the only thing crooked.
Red
Tyler backing Irwin R. Shyster.
Oh,
my goodness. I'll tell you one thing. You can make fun of IRS all you want to, but you have to give him credit for his athletic prowess. This man knows exactly what he's doing in the ring at all times. He is a technician, not only outside of the ring, but a technician on the inside.
Well, Irwin's what you call a sleeper. He don't look like much, but he's deadly.
Doesn't look like much. 240 pounds. He's about 6'4".
Well, none of it's in his legs.
I heard that. Maybe I'll tell Irwin.
Having a bad knee.
Yeah,
I was just
okay, right.
Yeah, we saw how bad your knee was.
Just last week.
Yeah.
All right.
You're doing fine.
Matter of fact, there was some question that a Macho Man asked after the match was over last week. He wondered whether or not you were really just fooling around. He wondered whether or not that you really did have a knee.
Let's call the action in the ring right now, Vince McMahon. Let's just forget about the past. Piper, no problem. Yeah, I'll get you coffee later.
Right. Nonetheless, there you see a submission hold, or at least a painful one, and IRS was holding onto the ropes a little bit earlier on just for additional pressure.
Oh, yeah, additional pressure is what's needed here.
And Mr. Red Tyler having his problems with IRS as just anyone might.
Irwin's slick. You got to give him that, man. He knows exactly where he's at in the ring. He knows his timing, and he's not afraid to take control.
Did you see how that guy broke that hold right there? He pancaked right out.
What match are you watching? He's being pancaked, all right. Irwin R. Scheister in complete control of this matchup all the way. And Mr. Scheister is sending Red Tyler in the ropes for the ride. Uh-oh. Up across the back. And down. And that, I believe, is what Mr. Scheister calls the write-off.
Write that fellow off. I didn't hear what he said there.
Please make welcome, as best you can, my special guest this week, Sensational Sherry and the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase.
Well, this should be very, very interesting, Roddy Piper.
Really?
And, need I remind you of that provision in your contract?
I know.
Okay.
Yes, teacher.
Everybody right here will not interfere.
Dad, plenty of weight?
I'm sure he is.
Oh, I won't interfere.
And I remind you as well, Macho Man, because you're not above going down to say hello to Sensational Sherry.
As you very well know, in my opinion, in the minds of many, Ted DiBiase and Sensational Sherry, you have your hands full, not only with your former bodyguard, your former employee, Virgil, but you've got your hands more than full, Mr. DiBiase, now with Rowdy Roddy Piper, too.
She's looking good, huh?
First of all, little man, let me address the issue of Virgil. Virgil, I want you to take a long, hard look at this lady. This lady is 100% class from head to toe. This woman, Virgil, has all of the qualities that I so desperately tried to instill in you. But you see, Virgil, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink. The biggest mistake you've ever made, Virgil, is by listening to Rowdy Roddy Piper, because you have all but sealed your fate. And now you, Piper.
What?
There's two things, Piper, that you do better than any man I've ever known in my life. First of all, run your big mouth. And second of all, stick your nose where it doesn't belong. You stuck your nose in my business at WrestleMania. And what did it get you?
A victory.
A very bad knee and a crutch. Oh, yes, I know. You've thrown the crutch away. But everybody knows, Piper, that you're a hothead. Everybody knows that you're a little crazy, that you've got a fuse about this long. I just hope, Piper, that you haven't thrown the crutch too far, because in the very near future, you're going to need it again.
Virgil and Rowdy Roddy Piper.
We get to hear her too,
there
huh?
There is one thing that you failed to realize, that the Million Dollar Man has more than either one of you will ever hope to have in one lifetime. So therefore, that makes this man more of a man than one of you will ever hope to be.
Put her eyeshadow on the caboose.
Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, along with his manager, Sensational Sherry. Just how sensational she is, time will tell.
I like my life, I know that.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall.
Here we go again. Spinning in this one. This is our feature here this week on Challenge. Take a look at that hunk of humanity, the Warlord.
Gonna have to put this one on a heavy cycle.
Oh, there's some music that you remember, Randall.
Yes, and Needy. That's my man, Brett the Hitman Hart. A great tag team partner, great friend of mine, doing great in singles now.
You guys were closer than brothers.
Of course, Brain wouldn't know anything about that. He's not close to anybody. Except when he gets into somebody's pocket. You know, they should put the Hitman's head in the rinse cycle and get all that grease out. The Hitman looking good. Oh, he's a fine technician. There's no doubt about that. But when you talk about strength and power, I mean, he's got the Warlord now. I mean, he's outmatched.
Uh-oh, some youngster's going to get a nice gift here.
A pretty young lady there is absolutely ecstatic. Too bad he don't have a couple of those. You could hide the whole face.
I knew you'd have something derogatory to say.
You know, just a couple weeks back on my show Primetime, I had the Warlord on and Slick. And the Warlord had a bad chest and a bad back.
And a bad attitude.
Oh, a very bad attitude. And he still bench pressed over 500 pounds 19 times.
19 consecutive reps.
And the only reason he quit was because Slick told him to. He didn't want to damage any part of his body. 19 times.
Don't you know you can't move
him? You believe that, Anvil?
Yes, I do. This guy, Warlord, is a very, very strong man. No question about that.
19 reps with 500 pounds?
Over 500 pounds. Don't you watch Primetime?
Yes, I watch Primetime.
Well, then you know. I'm not going to ask you, Monsoon, because I know you're always up with Jack Tunney. You're too busy to do. There's the agility on Bret Hart. Quite, yeah. Fun things.
Fun things?
Watching Primetime's fun.
Oh, nice maneuver by the Hitman.
That's why they call him the excellence of execution. Yeah! Give him one in the stomach, Hitman. Yeah!
Well, he had a great opportunity there. He had the big guy down on the canvas, and that's where he should have kept him, Anvil. Now he's in trouble.
Is he biting him? Yeah.
Sort of a late lunch.
WWF action is going to be returning to Portland, Maine at the Cumberland County Civic Center on Thursday night, May 30th, making his Portland debut, Irwin R. Scheister. In addition, you'll see Luke and Butch the Bushwhackers and the tag team champions, the Nasty Boys. Thursday night, May 30th, the return of live WWF action to the Cumberland County Civic Center in Portland, Maine.
Finish him! He's a piece of meat!
Warlord, very methodical in his style of attack. Look at this power display.
Throw him all the way to Calgary.
Not too many guys have survived the dungeon in Calgary, Alberta, Canada.
You can say that again. That's a miserable place.
Canada, you're right. The Hitman did, in fact, do that. He's a survivor.
He spent 5, 6, 7, 8 years with Neidhart. I mean, no offense.
We did have our moments.
Nice reversal, but Warlord with that power just turned it around once again. Hitman right now realizing what kind of power he's having to deal with here.
Now, as quick as Bret Hart is, you think he'd use that to his advantage. You think he'd be buzzing around the Warlord. But no, he's trying to take it to him. He's not going to recover here.
Don't count the Hitman out just yet.
Uh-oh, nobody home on that one.
The Hitman should roll out, get on that floor, shake the cobwebs loose, find out where he's at.
Take it out, brother. Come on.
There we go.
Downstairs in the bread basket goes the Hitman. Might be the only weak spot on this big guy.
Big run, House Rice. And another one. Give it to him, Hitman.
Look out. Rams him headfirst into the top turnbuckle. Going up to the second rope on the inside. The Hitman unloading.
Yeah, pepper the top of that ball, Dad.
I think the big guy got his wake-up call.
Hello. Still hasn't knocked him down.
Well, he did that.
So I say he's just about ready to knock him down.
Hitman second.
There's that patented elbow. Right in the throat.
Not going to beat him like that, though, Anvil. Too big a guy just to lay across and expect to hold him down. Irish whip, no reversal once again by the Warlord.
There's that quickness. Yeah.
Clothesline City slicks it in like that.
Ooh, that was close.
That was close. You're right, Slick. You got a gripe there. You tell him.
Look at that, Brain. Some of your tactics right there, baby.
Yeah, a lot of people copied a lot of things from the Brain.
Pendulum has swung a half a dozen times already in this one. And right now it's in the favor of the Hitman.
Notice the acceleration Brett has in all his moves. Watch.
Oh, look at that. Oh, from the outside, Slickster reaching up with that cane, clobbering the Hitman.
You're already doing it for
me. Yeah.
Oh, now he's going to get clobbered.
That's a little more like it. Hey, baby Hitman.
Uh-oh, he's got the cane now.
Here we go. Rams him right into the stool. Across the back.
That's it. Ring the bell.
Go get him, Brett. I believe we've had a disqualification here. Should be a disqualification on the Slickster, Anvil.
Absolutely right, Monsoon.
Well, now you don't know why Slickster did what he did.
Yeah, because he was worried about his man getting beat. Let's find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee's official decision, he has disqualified both men, therefore a double disqualification.
Well, I'll go along with that double disqualification. But whoever initiates it, that's the one who should be disqualified, and that's the one who should go home with a short end of the money.
Not always.
Let's go to our special report.
I was dumped by two pieces of trash. Two of Jimmy Hart's thugs. They did a number on me and handcuffed me to the ropes. But we all know who was behind this. And that's the Canadian Mountie coming to the ring with a 5,000-watt shock stick, a portable electric chair. Well, Punk, when that surge of electricity went through my body, all it did was make my blood boil. Boil with hate, Punk, for you, Canadian Mountie. The fact is, boy, we got to face reality. We got to deal with you in the hardest way of all. Get ready, Canadian Mountie. You're going to serve hard time.
It's barbershop time. With pitch tippers and all. Brutus, the barber beefcake. Getting things ready for his next appointment.
Those big scissors look pretty sharp. Sharper than beefcake looks.
You know, my next appointment has just arrived, and I couldn't be prouder than to be the one to introduce to you now the Immortal Hulk.
It's gonna go bananas in here. The roof is gonna come off. I can't see the rubbing.
I can't hear you. What?
Forget it.
Hulkamania. The Doubleman Twins. Look at the size of Hulk's arms.
And the size of the bandage.
Hulkster, it's obvious to me that you and all the Hulkamaniacs, brother, won a great victory in WrestleMania 7, brother. Woo! That Sergeant Slaughter has definitely shown his true colors when he chose to open a new phase, brother. You won the battle, brother, but the war rages on. Sergeant Slaughter has definitely declared war and shown that no lines are drawn, no rules are gonna prevail.
You know something, that's right, Brutus. When he threw the fire in my face after WrestleMania 7 in the locker room, it made all the Hulkamaniacs realize what he meant by no rules. And then when he casually strutted out here on the barbershop and made reference to your mug, brother, the way it was squashed by Mother Nature, maybe it's just a freak accident, but my casualty, my burn on the side of my face was by design. Sergeant Slaughter, that made me and all my Hulkamaniacs realize whether it was napalm, let it be napalm. Whether it's gasoline, let it be gasoline. Or whether it's Army, Navy, the Marines, tanks, guns, or bazooka, or out and out, hand-to-hand combat slaughter. Let's get it on, brother, because we're ready for you, and we're not afraid of anything that Sergeant Slaughter has in store for us. These are his rules, Brutus.
Well, you know something, Hulkster? I know that Sergeant Slaughter is definitely waiting for an opportunity to take you down so that maybe he can take and spray some Agent Orange or something all over those Hulkamaniacs, brother. What are you going to do when the horror sets in across the faces of all the Hulkamaniacs?
Well, you know, Barber, when you get ready for war, brother, you got to be ready to win. You got to put everything into it you got, man. Body, mind, soul, and everything. And you got to have something that you're fighting for. But there are casualties, man. There are horrors of war, brother. But it always reads in the children's faces, man. And if it was anybody else other than my little Hulkamaniacs, the horrors of war would be the end of Hulkamania. But if something would happen that the Hulkster would get hurt in this all-out-and-out war, the horrors of war would turn around and bite Sergeant Slaughter in the butt, brother, because those little Hulksters would fight for me. They'd stand in line, millions at a time, armed, ready, and pumped to whip Sergeant Slaughter. So when I get you in the ring, brother, it's not just going to be shave and a haircut, two bits. It's going to be Hulkamania is going to run wild until you call it quits. What you going to do?
Hulkamania indeed alive and well. Take a look. Look at that chest.
Andre, I want you coming to Mr. Fuji camp. I want you because you big. I want you make you bigger. Big money, you understand? You're rich, but I want to make you richer. I want to teach you to be very devious and mean.
I'm not sure I want to be that way.
Why?
Why? Give me a good reason to be that way.
You can make more money.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
How much more money?
Very more money, millions and millions of dollars. Perhaps we agree on contract? Andre? Huh? Waiters! Being big cake for big man.
Hey, wait a minute.
We celebrate with some big cake, big man.
Just a little warning there, for especially for you youngsters. You're supposed to eat the Superstars ice cream bars, not wear it.
How come that was one of my ice cream bars? They're always licking me. Even when I'm not there, they're licking me.
It's okay, Roddy Piper. It looked like safe ice cream to me.
Well, this is anything but safe here.
Enter at your own risk.
Is none other than a man that walks in darkness. Everybody knows Jake the Snake Roberts.
Now this should be a very interesting funeral parlor, as they all are.
Well, Jake should be at home there.
Nothing's gonna upset Jake the Snake Roberts, because he kind of dwells with these type of people.
Really?
That's what I've heard. Made it above, visited a funeral parlor, recently with Damien.
Welcome! I welcome you, Mr. Roberts, into my funeral parlor. I understand that you had a death in your family very recently.
Oh, that's what I was talking about.
Did you have?
Paul Bearer finds some humor in this.
Did you bury poor Damien in a pet cemetery? Did you have a choir? Did you sing? Mr. Roberts, did you shed a tear? should have called me. Maybe next time, when Earthquake gets you, you might need a double-sized casket.
Let me ask you something, my man. Are you afraid of anything? Any living thing? You see, it's okay not to fear death, my man. You've got to fear the living, because those are the ones that will hurt you. Now, as far as a double size for myself and Lucifer, do you think you've got something that can handle that snake, my man? Because I'll tell you something, Earthquake can't. And you don't have a box around here big enough for him either.
Oh, Mr. Roberts, I'm a mortician of excellence. I can handle anything, any kind of casket.
Is that right? You can do just about anything you want. You see, growing up, I learned the first breath I take just got me a little bit closer to the last breath. That's what death's about, my man. You fear the living. Now, this box, no way. Build a bigger box for Lucifer, man, because this won't work.
Oh, but I think this one will do just fine.
It won't work, I'm telling you. It's not near big enough.
I'm the mortician. This is my parlor. This casket will be fine.
Now we know where Lucifer is.
I thought Paul Bearer was very sympathetic. I think Jake the Snake Roberts is out of line.
You see, mysterious things do show up in mysterious places. And Lucifer and myself, we're both very bad boys.
Right here next week is when I'm going to be making my big announcement. It's gonna rock and shock the World Wrestling Federation. Remember, right here next week, my big announcement.
Welcome to the barber shop.
They love Brutus, don't they, Anvil?
They sure do. It looks like he got carried away with the scissors on his own outfit.
Let me introduce him to you. He calls himself the perfect Intercontinental Champion. And he's accompanied by his manager,
them, don't they, Jim?
They sure do. I think Weasel's too good of a name for Bobby Heenan.
Perfect.
It's too nice.
The hot dog days of summer are here again. A certain British bulldog is now the number one contender for the Intercontinental title. And I'm sure that you've heard the old saying, every dog has his day.
They better keep their eye on that Davey Boy Smith, I'm telling you, Monsoon.
Let me tell you something, Beefcake and everybody else. There's no doubt in my mind that the British Bulldog is the number one contender. He has the strength, he has the power, he has the wrestling knowledge, and I also know that he wants more than anything to bring the Intercontinental Championship belt back to England for the simple reason England has never had a winner in anything.
That's a lie.
Look at the Weasel,
you know,
put his 2 cents in.
Talk about hot dogs, let's talk about Winston. Because if that filthy, flea-infested rabid mutt wants to start growling and barking at Mr. Perfect, he's going to find himself on a hot dog bun with an extra dose of mustard. Maybe a rotisserie, huh? We'll have the family over for a picnic.
Well, you know, that's pretty amusing to me, gentlemen. But you know something? You're not messing with some little puppy dog here. I've seen this guy in action, and he's a full-blown attack dog, and he's foaming at the mouth, wanting to get a chance to sink his teeth into your Intercontinental belt.
These bulldogs are nasty.
Grab on and don't let go.
Oh, they got some big choppers.
If you're looking to take the Intercontinental Championship belt, British Bulldog, you're barking up the wrong tree. Whoa.
Interesting to say the least. We'll be back with the Big Boss Man in just...
The Undertaker's gonna love him. He's the only person walking...
Are you making fun of me?
Trust me.
I didn't say anything about your hair, did I?
No. He's the only person walking the street that's been embalmed and still alive. If you want to call that living.
Okay, thank you very much. Have a seat now because I'm going to introduce someone else. This is going to
be okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
What you're going to hear now is...
I got it with him.
That's a man. Real.
I know I can take him.
Yes, I'm not so sure. Here's Paul Bear!
What do you have in here,
honey? A very well kept secret. You won't find out.
Could I have peek in here?
Oh.
Now, you go take a look in here.
All right. I was going to let you peek.
Okay, let me just take a look. I don't know if anyone really wants to peek or not, but I can tell you that the Ultimate Warrior is likely to... What do you...
If you had a mayonnaise jar, it'd be a lot easier.
Well, yeah, I'll tell you. These chickens going very fast.
And they're not going anyplace.
Well, what's the thing?
Yeah, you can look in the,
I know it.
It's Cleveland, 68.
In any event, the Ultimate Warrior is obviously very hot on the trail of, I think, something... You're missing the name Ultimate Warrior. Every time I hear that name, my blood pressure goes up.
You never know it.
Oh, the Ultimate Warrior. But you know, have you noticed the change in the Ultimate Warrior? He's mellowed out a little bit. He don't act like he used to. He thinks about when he was locked inside that airtight casket, when he was grasping for the breath of air that wasn't there at all. And then a few weeks later, my Undertaker appeared at ringside out of nowhere. Do you remember the look on his face? Do you remember?
The whole couple of weeks ago, he was on our program here. He was very calm. He was very quiet. He wasn't the warrior of old. You put the fear in him.
Yes, he was almost across that bridge into the unknown. But his friend saved him. Oh, yes. His friend saved him. Next time, they won't.
Right now we're going to take you to a matchup involving Dick the Snake Roberts, but I understand you have one.
All right, we're back in only on prime time. Are you going to have something like this? Exactly what do we have
here, Mr. Bear?
Oh, Mr. McMahon, next to the embalming room, the casket showroom is the most important room in the funeral home. So I would like to show you just a small sample of what kind of caskets we have to offer.
You have to put the players in
there. Oh, if you'd like to, there's some wheels down there, Mr. Haynes.
Thank you.
First of all, we have a nice silver gunmetal, 20 gauge silver.
Oh, how about that?
That's
nice.
Open
really
up
nice.
On the inside. Goose down, steady pillow.
Goose down?
Yeah.
Who cares?
Wait.
Oh,
the family care. It's so nice.
The family care.
Oh, the family care.
Okay. Well, I understand it.
This is a copper casket made out of copper. Precious metal.
Hence the name, huh?
You know, this is the last thing you can do for a family member. Buy them something nice for their final internal resting place.
And read the will.
Oh, yeah.
But I understand, like, somebody who likes waterproof
beautiful
stuff like that.
Oh, we have an airtight seal on here. This is what the Ultimate Warrior will want to see, is the airtight casket. Ask him about that. Oh, yes.
Is your, like,
some sort of guarantee you get, you know, with
lifetime guarantee, of course. Lifetime guarantee. Beautiful blue. If you have blue eyes, if grandma has blue eyes,
your
put
eyes
it in there.
The eyes are going to be closed.
Oh, that's all right. They know grandma's eyes were blue. Oh, yeah. Another goose down pillow. And last but not least, oh, yeah.
Another gunmetal gray. I've got
all right. Close. You know,
what model?
Well, maybe you can put a horse in there. Yeah. I only have first-class tactics in my parlor.
Mm-hmm,
and
nice.
You know, right now I would like to introduce the man who's going to fill all these tactics and another one for the ultimate warrior, my Undertaker. Yes, my Undertaker.
Well, we'll be back as we continue with more.